Hey, what is up, guys? It is Limited Llama back with another Sorare MLB video. In this video, I'm going to be talking about how to use FantasyPros to find your ideal lineup inside of Sorare. So this is the third video in my series about using FantasyPros in combination with Sorare. And if you haven't checked out the other two videos, I would recommend doing so. They'll be in the description or up here in the corner. So make sure to check those out. They're really helpful. The first one is about setting it up. And then the second video is about finding really good value players using FantasyPros. And this video is assuming that you already have a team set up in Sorare. And the point of this video is to show you how FantasyPros can help you find the best lineup given the players that you have inside of Sorare. Now, as I've kind of gone through this, I've realized that there are some limitations to using FantasyPros. And I'll point those out during the process. So just be aware, it's not a perfect one-to-one simulator of Sorare, but I have found it helpful in just giving me a general idea of which players are really helpful for a given week and which players I should probably bench. So the first thing that you're going to do, assuming that you've already set up the league, is you're going to go over here to My Leagues and click Leagues, and then you're going to click this Manual Import button right here. And what this will do is it'll allow you to add in players based on a plain text document. So inside of the league host, you click Other Plain Text. And then in here, you're going to paste in your team name at the top and then all of your players below. So I already have like a document set up where I just add in my players as I go along. And I would recommend that you do the same because that'll allow you to easily just copy and paste over. And when you get a new player or delete a player, right, you can just delete them in the text document and then re-import it into FantasyPros. And then once you do that, you click the import button. And then I would recommend scrolling through all of these players and making sure that all of them match the ones that are on your list so that you have all of your players ready to go. Now, once you do that, you click the next button. And at this point, all of your players should be loaded into your team. And what you can do right now, before we even get into the lineup assistant, is you can see how well these players are expected to do in a given day. So Jose Ramirez, today he's expected to get 9.26 fantasy points, right? Michael Chavez, 9.71 fantasy points. Austin Slater, 10.38. And then you can see, right, some of these players aren't pitching, but the ones that are, you know, 18.73 fantasy points. So you can already see how beneficial this is. You can see which of your players are doing well today, but you can also base this on a given week. So one of the big limitations with using FantasyPro for Sorare is that FantasyPros is based on the fantasy, like baseball fantasy schedule, which uses entire weeks. So week 19 is from Monday, August 22nd until August 28th, which is next Sunday. However, Sorare runs two tournaments per week. So it's Monday to Thursday and then Friday to Sunday. So as you kind of look at the players' expected fantasy points for a given week, you kind of want to cut that in half to see how many they would be expected to get just based on, you know, Monday through Thursday. You can also, as you get closer, right, I can click tomorrow, see how many points each of these players is looking to get tomorrow. And then, for example, if you're setting up your team on a Friday morning, you can see both tomorrow and today, and that'll give you Friday's stats and Saturday's stats, and then Sunday's stats you can kind of assume will be roughly the same. So you can use this to project how your players are going to do in a given week. But the feature that I find even more useful is this lineup assistant over here on the side. And this lineup assistant, what it does is it loops through all of your players and it tries to find the optimal lineup for a week. Now, as a reminder, it's using the entire week. So you want to make sure that the players that it has, for example, the pitchers that it has, are actually going to be pitching in the Monday through Thursday set that you're lining up for. But once this loads, you can see it gives you a list of the players that it recommends you playing. And then it has your players benched and then your expected points. Now, up here at the top, you're going to want to set this to the next week, right? So week 19. And then we'll wait for that to load. And it'll give you the optimal lineup for the upcoming week. Now, it's important to note here that this is going to be using all of the players that you've imported, which will include any common players that you have. So right here, all of these players, except Travis d'Arnaud, are actually silver players for me, right? They're the limited players. So Jose Abreu, Amed Rosario, Harold Ramirez, these are all limited players. Travis d'Arnaud is not, but this actually worked out pretty well for me. If you come in here and like half these players are common players, what you're going to do is go into edit settings, and then you're going to go through and click bench on all of your common players. And this will allow you to only start the players that can actually play in like the limited competition. Or if you want to play in a rare competition, you would bench all of your non-rare players so that you can only play rare players, and then the system will optimize it for playing only the rare players or only the limited players. So once you've done this, you can see how many points it expects to get you for the entire week, and then you would probably cut this roughly in half for just the 4 days, right? It says Jose Abreu, Amed Rosario, Harold Ramirez, Jose Ramirez, and then Will Benson is the fourth player, or the fifth player. And then these are all your hitters, obviously, and then if you want the pitchers, you go over to the pitching side, and it has Mike Minor, Austin Gomber, Andres Munoz. One important thing to note here is that FantasyPros has some players as both relief pitchers and starting pitchers, whereas SoRare only has them as starting pitchers. So, for example, Austin Gomber, I think he's inside of SoRare, right? Let's look at Austin Gomber. Yeah, so you can see right here, he's actually a starting pitcher inside of SoRare, but FantasyPros treats him both as a relief pitcher and as a starting pitcher. So you might want to set him to be benched, for example, so that then you would only see your starting pitchers. All right, so I just went through and marked all of my common players as benched so that now we're only looking at the limited players. And the first thing that I notice here is that we're running into the same issue that we've had before, where our relief pitcher is actually a starting pitcher inside of SoRare. So Jesus Luzardo, it says he's a relief pitcher in FantasyPros, but in SoRare, he's only treated as a starting pitcher. So I'm going to kind of scroll through these lineups and see which one has a relief pitcher pitching. So right here, we can see Andres Munoz. He's a relief pitcher. He's pitching. And then we have Zach Gallen as the starting role. So right here, I'm going to run with Zach Gallen. And then we're going to go with Andres Munoz. And now we're going to hop back over to the hitting side of things, right? And it recommends corner infielder, going to go with Jose Ramirez here. Middle infielder recommends Amed Rosario. Outfielder recommends Harold Ramirez. And then the extra player recommends Jose Abreu, right? This utility player. And then as the flex player, I'm going to go back over to the pitching side of things. And it recommends Johnny Cueto as the second pitcher right here. So I'll go ahead and pick him up. And then this is essentially like my ideal squad according to FantasyPros, right? It has all of the players that it projects to do the best for this upcoming week. Now, as a reminder, this is like slightly inaccurate because it includes Friday through Sunday, whereas this tournament is only for Monday through Thursday. So one thing that I would do is make sure that we aren't missing out on any games played. So for example, in the center infielder, the middle infielder role, right, Amed Rosario is only playing 3 games because they have an off day tomorrow. But it's possible that, you know, William Contreras might have been playing 4 games if they didn't have an off day, or Colton Wong could have been playing 4 games. And then if that were the case, I might switch Amed Rosario out for a player that's playing 4 games. But in general, FantasyPros is just kind of a guideline for, hey, these are the best players that you have for this upcoming week. And then you can kind of adjust based on, you know, which players are playing in more games, which ones are playing in less games. But I found it helpful to give me just a general idea of which players are going to get me the most points to maximize my chances of a win. So that's all I have. That's kind of all the tools that I've used on FantasyPros. If you haven't, I would recommend giving it a shot. I found it useful, and I think it's going to be useful going forwards as I kind of try to upgrade my team, and it'll help me to find really solid players who maybe are cheaper on SoRare. So if you haven't, go ahead and subscribe down below. I create daily SoRare videos talking about how my teams are doing, and if you enjoy that type of content, give me a like and go ahead and subscribe. So that's all. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys later.